Hello, Classical Classroom listeners. This is your host, Dacia. If you are a regular Classical Classroom listener or a brand new one and you're super excited and you want to keep us around, go to iTunes, subscribe to us, and rate and review us. The powers that be, they see these numbers, they see your ratings and your reviews, and they say to themselves, this is an amazing show, and we should keep it around. So if that's important to you, please do it. Anyway, I'm going to shut up now, and please enjoy the episode. My name is Dacia Clay. I'm the audio librarian here at Classical 91.7. While I'm a real librarian, I have a deep, dark secret. I know very little about classical music. I grew up listening to rock, and I know something about jazz. But when it comes to classical, but I really want to learn. So, every week on this show, a classical music expert will give me a piece of classical music they think I should know, and then we'll discuss it. Come learn with me in the classical classroom. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Classical Classroom. I'm Dacia Clay, and here with me today is Yundi. Yundi started playing piano when he was 7. Before that, he played the accordion. So cool. He's toured all over the world, and he's played with many of the world's greatest orchestras. In addition to his work as a pianist, Yundi is also involved in humanitarian work. He acts as an ambassador for the Red Cross Society of China. Yundi gained a lot of recognition when he won first prize at the Chopin International Piano Competition at the age of 18, which made him the youngest and the first Chinese winner of the competition. Since then, he's become known as a Chopin expert and was even given a gold medal for merit to culture by the government of Poland for his work. Yundi, welcome to the Classical Classroom.
Hi.
So I assume that since you've won the Chopin competition and now you're going to be on the jury of the Chopin competition and you just put out this new CD of Chopin Preludes, that you're going to be teaching me about Beethoven.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. I think we're going to talk about Chopin.
Yeah, I think it's a wonderful experience to record Chopin Prelude because this year is one of the, I think, celebrating year for me to celebrate winning Chopin competition 15 years.
So it's been 15 years since you won the Chopin competition.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah, and also October will be the jury towards for the Chopin competition. So it's a big difference than 15 years ago and competitors, and this year will be the youngest jury. So it's
wow.
A big challenge for me. So that's why I made decision this year. I record and perform Chopin in the world. So
okay. So what do you think? You're obviously a big fan of Chopin. Your career had its roots in Chopin, and now you've gone back to Chopin. What does Chopin contribute to classical music that was so unique that makes you love his work so much?
As he says, he's so genius. First of all, he's especially the piano work is fantastic. So it's one of the best, I think, that you can find for the arrangement for piano.
Mm-hmm.
And he really knows the 88 keys. So every key he knows exactly. And also his composition is, every time when you hear Chopin, he's really, you know, he gives his soul and he gives his heart and love in mm-hmm. the music. That's people always loved him.
Yeah, it's definitely very... I listened to the whole CD and the whole thing was just kind of an emotional, not to sound too cheesy, but it was kind of an emotional journey. You go through a full kind of range of emotions.
Right.
Let's talk a little bit about who Chopin was. We actually haven't talked about him a whole lot on this show. So can you just tell us a little bit about who he was?
He's really the composer for the piano side. And
mm-hmm.
his whole life just composed for piano. So there's
really?
No anybody else composer like Liszt or Beethoven. So they have a symphony, they have a violin, cello, and many others. But Chopin only wrote the music for piano. So that's why he's so special, I think, the connection with the piano. So I think his all music and with different technique and also his melodic and his poetic, his romantic side is really on 19th century is one of the most important for me is my music king.
So From what I understand, he lived in the 1800s, but where was he from? Where did he grow up?
I think he's from Poland. He grew up, but he during that time has a war, you know, during the wartime. So he cannot stay in his country. He run to France. So he died quite young. I think around 30, 33 or 34. But wow. And after he died, he asked his country. So he want to back for his heart. Uh-huh. His heart moved back to from France to Poland.
So basically he was taken from Poland because of the terrible circumstances that were going on there with the war. He moves off to France, but then he misses Poland, and so he comes back.
That's also, you can see a lot of his music also is emotion from his native.
So it actually really affected his music and his composition.
Right, that's right.
So now, what about these preludes? Where did they come from? What were the circumstances going on in Chopin's life when he composed these? Can you tell me a little bit about that? And also, I'm calling them pieces, but I don't actually know what a prelude is, or if I'm even saying it correctly.
I think prelude is from each small different piece. So mm-hmm. each small piece have each different character. So like, for example, the most well-known 15th Raindrop is one of the piece. So he actually wrote this piece in Spain, this Mallorca island.
Oh, okay. So he wrote these pieces
during
Mallorca.
His, I think, one of the vacation, he feels sick. So then he went to Mallorca island and to rest. During that time, he wrote this composition.
Oh, okay. So he was like convalescing in Mallorca, but he wasn't actually living there.
Yes. And it's inspired from the raindrop. So you, after the raining, so Chopin see the raindrop come up from the house.
Okay, so he's like looking at the raindrops falling.
Yes, from or the window. Uh-huh. So that gives his basic idea.
So
the
so
left
cool.
hand, the many melodies, the tone from left hand is inspired from the raindrop.
Oh,
that
whoa,
you can whoa. Hear from the. From the music. You can see the front of the table and look at the outside of the window. You see the oil ring job come
up. Yeah, it can totally sort of see the rain falling. You know, you're sitting inside of your house, you're watching it come down the windows. Very sort of like tender sounding piece.
So when that time he also still have a relation with George Song, is probably his lovers. So
So George Song, the writer.
Yes, and so that music is doing his he's quite sick, but he mm-hmm. still have a lot of emotion for I think energy to want to write something. Then that this piece has come from that time.
Okay, that kind of makes sense because so he's on this island,
right?
And he's you know recovering from illness, but he's also there with his lover, and it's beautiful there. And so that you know
right.
these pieces seem really emotional, like they're kind of all over the place, but they're all very emotional.
Yes.
Take a listen to one that's totally different.
So you try the number eight?
Number eight, okay. Oh wow, what a shift. So what is going on? This music just, there's no introduction, there's nothing, it just
right,
starts.
Right, this is like a typical Preludes style. So just every part is emotion and the color, agitato, and his feeling, he's so not confident, but he's still looking for something.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like searching all over the place.
It's searching, yeah.
Yeah. Let's listen to, there is on the CD as well, you've got the full range. These are all of his preludes, right?
Right, right.
So take us to your personal favorite.
I think it's one of the, not only personal favorite, but I think this is one of the outstanding technique piece from this prelude. It's number 16.
Number 16, okay. Holy moly. So tell me what's going on here. What is this prelude about?
This is also about passionate, and the Chopin just gift his fire on the music. It's not usual to do like this, because Chopin's always more melodies, as you already hear, it's very poetic, very elegant, but this is really something different.
Oh yeah, I mean, you kind of always hear people characterize Chopin's work as being so sort of gentle, but this is definitely not that. Maybe he was having a bad day. Wow, that was amazing. Your playing is amazing.
Thanks.
Wow, like Chopin has such a range that must be really challenging as a performer, to be asked to go very slow and then very fast and to play with all of these different emotions. I know that you also play a lot of Beethoven. So like, what's different about playing Chopin than playing Beethoven or other composers?
I think Chopin's music for me is totally different, and it's most unique, I think, composer from any others, because I just played Beethoven Emperor Concerto yesterday. So I think I'm listening to Chopin's music, I think it's totally changed my mind. It's a different side. Totally. One side is from very philosophy, very logical music, and another style of the German romantic side to a really central romantic area music.
Yeah, it's very like Beethoven is very, yeah, sort of big sounding, and this,
yeah,
is very,
and the logic
intimate.
And and philosophy.
Uh-huh. Well, take us to, let's do one more of the preludes before you have to take off.
I think the end, the 24th is really nice. It's outstanding and passionate, but also dramatic.
Okay, let's listen to that one.
You can hear from the melody, the dramatic,
yeah,
how Chopin's also fighting probably with, he's sick that time, so he wants to fight him with his problem.
Yeah. What was he sick with?
I think it's, I don't know, the part, the near the heart, that when you breathe
okay.
the part. He had, during that time, he has been catch a cold and he's coughing.
Oh.
So.
Oh, man. So maybe he had pneumonia or something like that.
By that time, you don't have so many medicine you can eat.
Yeah, they didn't have the good drugs back then. But he's still composing.
Yeah.
Wow. And this and music like this is still coming out of
him. Yeah, you can feel hope.
Will you talk a little bit about the technical side of this? I mean, we've talked a lot about the emotion that's inherent in these, but when it comes to actually playing the music, like what is involved in playing Chopin that's different?
Yes, Chopin's music is the technique first for me is tone color, that you should find the right tone color. So that is one of the most important style for Chopin. And other hand, you need left hand, you always is a tempo for Chopin. But right hand, you is so many, sometimes many rubato, but you will not rubato your left hand as a basic like metronome, the tempo, but you only do a rubato in the right hand.
Okay, so like both hands are doing something totally different.
Yes, yes.
That's crazy. Nice. Well, Yundi, thank you so much for being on The Classical Classroom. It was really great to talk to you. Thanks for introducing me to Chopin.
Thank you. My pleasure.
All right. That does it for this episode of Classical Classroom. For more Classroom, go to HoustonPublicMedia.org/classroom. Subscribe to us on iTunes. Make sure to rate and review us, won't you? You can also follow us on Twitter and Tumblr, or you can send me an email at dclay@HoustonPublicMedia.org. Thanks today to audio producer Todd, a Confederacy of Todds, Hulslander, for twiddling knobs. Thanks to program director Sinjin Flynn for not showing his arms today. Thanks to editor Mark DiClaudio for his piercing Ewok eyes. Yub yub. Thanks to intern Nick Dolworth for whatever it is that he does. Thanks to Yundi for being here today. Thanks to me for saying words. And thanks to you for listening. We'll catch you next time.